Hi, in this part 2 of the arcade structure grasshopper tutorial, we will continue from where we left in the first part. This is what we did. We created this model and we will continue. If you didn't watch the first part, please watch it and then watch this video here. So now, what we will do is to create an array, a linear array of this module. So linear array. Now the direction is the x direction. Also, what I need to plug here is the distance between each instance. So I will take this top line here and multiply it by 2 and supply this as the distance. So here I have the top line. Math, multiply. I will use a panel and type 2. And use the length. I can hide the original one. For the count, I will create a slider from 1 to, let's say, 30. Now, I need to create a mirror of this that goes in this direction. To do this, if you look in the top viewport, I need to create a plane that is at 45 degrees. Let's start from the origin, and I will use this plane as the mirror plane. So I will choose, I will create an XZ plane. You can also choose a YZ plane, doesn't matter. And I will rotate this 45 degrees. Degrees, 45. I will bring a mirror component. And now I got this. I will look at the data structure here. I can see that I have two groups, two lists inside of this list here. I don't need this kind of data structure. I want them all to be in the same group. So now all the elements are in the same list. Before, we had two lists, two sub lists. The first list was these halves, and the other list was the other halves of these arcades. So now they are all in the same list. Okay, now what we need to do is to take all of these and rotate them 180 degrees to complete this structure. So I will do a B-rep join and join them all together as one B-rep. I will flatten this. Okay, so now I will rotate this 180 degrees around the geometrical geometric middle. I will create a bounding box for this. Now here, by default, the bounding box will create a bounding box for each instance. I want one bounding box for the whole thing. So right click and choose union box. So now I only have one bounding box. Now the benefit of using the bounding box is that at the beginning I will use its geometric center as the center of the rotation. But after that, I will use the top part of this bounding box to create the ceiling and the other ceiling that has an offset. And the good thing about this is that since the bounding box adapts to any change I do with these arcades, like the height and the number of these arcades, everything I build starting based on this bounding box will adapt. And everything will stay parametric. So first I will extract the geometric center. So from surface area, rotate. Degrees, and then I will put 180. Again, I will join these B-wraps. These. Okay, now I will explode this bounding box because I need the top part of it, the top surface. So from surface, deconstruct B-wrap. I'll bring in a list item. I need to guess the index of the top, so I will create a slider from 1, from 0 to 5. So it's the number 5. Extrude. Z direction. And I will choose a value like, let's say 30 centimeters for now. Okay, now I will explode this one too. I want to grab the top surface also. List item. I will start with 5 because I think this is the correct one. Now, this top part, I want to make it, you know, wider. So what I can do with this surface here, I can go to parameters and bring a curve parameter. When I plug the surface to it. So what this does, this curve parameter will grab the boundary of this face and create a closed 2D shape. Now I can offset this. Choose a value like 30 centimeters. I will extrude this. Z. I will start with a value of 40 centimeters for this one. Now, as you can see, the extrude is opened from top and bottom, so I will add a cap holes component. This will close this extrusion. I can hide everything. I need to give thickness for these arcades here. I will use this plugin called Popperfish. You can download it from Food for Rhino. I will put a link for it in the description. After installing it, you can double click and type offset, and you will find this component, offset surface. If you like to see where any component come from, you can use Control Alt and click on it, and you can see where to find it. I will choose a thickness of 30 centimeters for now. I want the thickness to be inwards, so I can right click and type here in expression minus X. Now, as you can see here, there is some intersection between those two. So what I can do here, first let's see the data structure to see if everything is in one list. Okay. So I will right click and choose flatten. And what I can do here is I can go to intersect menu, shape, solid union. When I hide everything here, you can see that now this boolean union helped me to get rid of this intersection here. Now I can start giving some colors to these objects. Custom preview. Swatch. I can choose the same color for this thickness. So I can plug this in the same component and hide this. Now for the top ceiling, I can choose a different color. Now we are done. I can change the height. And you can see how this thickness and the top ceiling adapts, because these are derived from the bounding box. Also, I can change the top length. This will give me another form for the arcade. I can play with the width of this bottom part. I can control from where the arc starts. Here I can increase or decrease the number of these arcades. For example, I can type 12. I'll keep it small for faster calculations. I can control this and the offset. I can control the thickness of the ceiling here. So basically that's it for this tutorial. Hope you like it. And if you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you in the next video. Thank you.